I would like to introduce my team members. That's Akshit, who is in the optics subgroup and also 3GS part. Anupam has done 3GS and optics also. Sachin is tester and the Blender integration part. Pragati has handled all the backend part in Java. And me and Snehal has done the mechanics part, and Rishabh is the front-end developer of our team. So this is the outline of our presentation. First, I'll talk about the objective of our project, then the technologies that we used to develop the framework that we have created, then the demonstration part, then the numbers and metrics involved, then our learnings and challenges, and the future scope of our project. So the main objective of our project was to develop an animation creation framework which is interactive and easy to use. As most of my team members are from software quota, who struggled to create animations while participating in the software quota challenge, they spent a lot of time in learning what is 3JS, what is PyLibrary, and read its complete documentation. Then they were able to create the animations by writing the code for object creation, object selection, drag and drop, user control, and everything which is required to create animations. Now, as we all have that experience, using that experience, we tried to build a platform which makes the process of creating animations much simpler by reducing the number of lines of code that user has to provide for creating any animations. And as an application part, I would say that our platform fills the gap between the graphics person and the software person, because a graphics person can create better scenes than a software expert, but a software expert can create much better animations by writing better code. So our framework is flexible to combine both the technologies. Now, these are some of the technologies that we used in our project. 3JS, which is a JavaScript library for creating 3D animations. For database part, we used MySQL. For backend, Java, and for 3D modeling and making some advanced objects, we used Blender. And for the front-end part, we used HTML, CSS, and Bootstrap. Now for the demonstration part, I would like to invite Anupam and Akshit.
So we are going to show a video demo. Because of short of time, we will be going to create an animation through our framework. This is our main page. We are going into category mechanics. The panel, the settings, these are the basic features we have. Change theme, choose objects, animation code editor, drag and drop control, concept editor, user control, static code editor, save progress, save as, and write. You will see the usage of these along by making an animation by an example. So what now user is doing is setting the background. It just gets easier by just a click. He can change a background. While in the 3JS library, you just have to write tons of lines of code to just create this animation, while we have provided an interface where he can click and get an animation. For this, we have choose objects. Here we can drag and drop an object and it creates a 3JS object, while in 3JS you have to write codes for this object also. So here we can change the color of the object. For this also in 3JS we have to write codes and all that stuff. We have removed that feature for writing the code. We have just provided a graphical interface where he can change very easily by changing the opacity, like he can change material. There are different kinds of material in 3JS provided, which depend, like this is a wireframe material. You can see the object in a wireframe material. And for this also we have to write codes in 3JS, while we have provided a simple user interface. Right now we cannot see the object. The object is showing black because we have not added the light. For Fong material to show, we have to add lights to the scene. Now we are going to add light. So here we are adding the light. We can change the intensity, color, and anything we want to create, how we want the scene to look. We can have 4 to 5 number of lights, a spotlight, a point light, and different kinds of light. We can change intensity, how they are going to look. You can see the shining effect around the ball of the ball to create a more realistic effect in that. For all this stuff, in 3JS, what we have done in our software Kota, we have to write a lots of code just to change this, just to set up these lights. We tried to remove that part by just providing a GUI setup. So we can change the radius of the ball. So we have chosen a ball. Now the user is choosing a wedge system and changing the color like we changed in the ball panel. So this is how he can create scene by just dragging and dropping. He don't know how to write a code for this. So here he created a two wedge system and a ball. So now we are going to write the code for the animation part, for what basic logic of physics is, for defining the variables like gravity, how the motion will happen, all the stuff. We are going to write that, we are going to define variables like gravity and all that, from where to start the motion. For this, the software people just have to write the code for the motion. So here we are writing the code, basic code for the animation, required logic, basic logic. So this is our another editor code, animation code, where the animation code for the motion is written. So the user is defining the logic, how the motion is done by the effect of gravity on wedges. Now you can see by the logic which user provided, the ball, the motion of the ball is happening. We can add user controls. These user controls are for changing, like we want to give user more control over the objects. Like we want the user to be able to change the gravity of the surrounding space while he is experimenting. These user controls will be shown when the user clicks on run animation part. So there was user control, where we provide user to control the object, like we surrounding or changing the properties of the objects. That's why what 3JS provides us is to control the objects, like we can create the object in Blender, but the animation, more interactive way that 3JS provides, we have incorporated that also. Like the creator of the animation can define what a user can change in this. Like he has defined that he can change the gravity of the object. So that was the save. He saved the object. Now we are going to see it on our dashboard. These are the saved experiment list. We are going to show it on our live site, the save experiments. So this is our main site, eShiksha website. So when the user runs, he gets the control what he added at the creation time. Like he can change the gravity to 15.7 rather than 10. So the motion of the ball moves according to that. You can add display panels, what is the speed and everything to make it more interactive manner. Like, because physics cannot be learned in animation, it's more about experimenting, how things change. So we tried to implement that.
What was the property changed when you just showed the live one?
It was gravity.
The gravity, okay.
Yes, sir.
But the motion,
yes, sir,
was not showing the actual way the gravity looked. For example, it was slow on the slope, it was fast on the horizontal field. And again, it was fast on the ascent. So that is kind of anti-gravity, what was happening.
No, sir. What was there was the logic written for that code was, when a ball is dropped from this wedge at a corner. So the logic was still continuing about that. So
in between, the things were changed.
Yeah, in between. But the initial logic, but that was the problem of the logic initially. The logic was written by the developer. He can write any logic he wants. If you find...
Yeah, can you just open that?
Yes.
Is this default gravity?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see this, while it goes up, it speeds up, which is not possible, right?
No, sir.
It just gets a push from somewhere and then it just goes up.
Sir, actually, this might be the problem with the screen of this laptop, because in this laptop, we define the parameters as it has a wide screen. In this laptop, the screen is not that wide.
Yes, sir, lag. There is a lag.
Yeah, there is a lag.
Because I think in laptop, it's working fine.
No, the lag I can understand, but that lag cannot be separate for horizontal movement versus diagonal movement. It has to be uniform everywhere. The change of speeds are slightly odd. I think so. It can't go, just a push cannot happen to this thing.
So whatever it is, our framework provides a way where user can write the logic. There might be a problem with the logic we have.
So basically, ball is following what user wrote about it. So
that's what I'm asking. Is it default gravity?
No, sir. There is no default.
There is no default.
User defines
the logic.
My point is that when you have such templatized version, like you started from some interface where it said run, right?
Yes, sir.
So when you start run, the good idea is to have it at default, which is the default gravity, which will happen in real life, right? It should follow something as default, because how will the user understand what is going wrong here? They'll only visibly see things wrong here, but something should be shown as default. And obviously, this is a great option to change and show according to the user perspective that they want to change anything. Perfectly fine. Usability is great. The problem is that learnability will get hampered if it is not showing the default anytime.
So basic thing is, we provide a framework where user can write what default value he has to show, what gravity does. He defines what gravity does. So basic thing is, the user defining the experiment might done it in a wrong manner, but he can done it a right way.
Yeah,
we just provide a framework where he can do anything.
I understand that. I'm saying.
Yes, sir. No, it's just a demo. He can create anything from that. We're just providing a demo.
Yes, I know. It is like, for example, I open any word processor. By default, it will have a black as a text input thing.
Yes, sir.
Obviously, I can write yellow text also.
Yes, sir.
But if you start showing me a document with its white text on a white paper, I will not see anything. So I'll think that nothing is getting written. And I'll start at contemplating whether I am writing or if the laptop is not showing me or what is happening.
Yes,
sir. So there has to be something called default, and then you can give an option saying that now you change whatever parameters you want and see the results.
So
that
basic
is fine.
The thing is, we didn't simulate gravity. What is gravity? Our software does not know what is gravity. We just provided a framework where user defines what is gravity. What you are getting there is what user defined gravity is. How the things will change when he changes the gravity. Because we cannot simulate whole gravity, because we have that library fizzy.js which simulate gravity and all that stuff. But it takes very high computational power, which loads your computer, and it does not work very good. The graphics were very slow. We tried that. So
now what have you defined here as a user?
So we defined
we wrote an equation.
So what is that equation doing?
Yeah, so we have written actually a wrong equation, that's why it's following a wrong path. So we are not creating a physics engine, because that's not practical for us. Yeah. So we are just providing a framework for user to create animations.
See, all this, whatever you are creating is for some users, and
yes,
your aim is to teach physics in a better way, right?
Yes.
Is that your objective?
Yes.
At some point, yes, at a very global level. So, obviously, I like the software prowess you are showing in this, the way you can do it. But it should not be at the cost of learning of physics, right? So if you give something which is wrong as a default, and then not even mention that, then it will be very difficult for people to learn the right things.
No, I'll just answer that. Their objective is not to teach physics. Okay. Their objective, one of the specifications was something called EJS, Easy Java Simulations, which was built by some professor in Europe somewhere, I think Holland or Netherlands or something. Okay, that claimed, okay, that a teacher, physics teacher, can create animations. Okay, it was based on that. Okay, so he had these objects, okay, which are there, and I can attach an equation, x of that object is equal to this, y of that object. I can define variables, okay, and use the variables in the equation. Okay, so that is exactly what they are doing. So they have defined a variable called gravity. Okay, they have written the equation wrong. So it is the physics teacher who is wrong, not their software. Okay. So basically, I'm sure they have written the equation wrong. All that thing is, it works on that thing is not there because it's consistently showing that it speeds up on the way up. Okay. So that is consistent. So the equation is wrong. Okay. But that doesn't mean the framework is wrong. The framework, the basic idea behind this is we have used my library, okay, to admit people through software quota. Okay, now those people had to work with 3JS to create scenes. Okay, and a lot of comments were that this does not look good, you increase that, but that is not what we want to test when we admit people. We want to test their programming skills. Okay, so according to me, programming skills are there to capture the physics equation, okay, to capture the boundary condition. When the ball hits that, then the equation has to change. Actually, it doesn't have to change, but collision detection, etc., that is what we want to test. So ideally, what we will do next year, okay, if we want to run the software quota again, okay, we will, up to their scene creation, okay, we will supply. Okay, so the animation, because every stage has got a save. Okay, so we will supply something with this, okay, and we'll ask the user, now you supply the animation code and you supply the user control code, and then I get the animation. Okay, so the basic programmer's job is now limited to animation code, okay, as well as the user control, what are the user control which we specify. Okay, so that is the reason. Ideally, they also have experimented with that. Okay, ideally we may not even use 3JS to create the scene. Okay, so we can use Blender to create the scene, okay, and give it to 3JS as a JSON file. Okay, so I get this thing and with all the colors and all that. Okay, and I'll leave it to the software quota people. Now you simulate that, there should be control over gravity, there should be control over the angle, which they have not done. So I can drag and drop the angle. So this is what I'll specify. And all the software person has to do is write that animation code, check it, and that's it. So that is the basic idea behind it. Okay. So create a framework by which I can test, or I can assign a job, a programming job, not a visual job, not a graphics editor job. So separation was the thing. Okay. So in the next year software quota, probably we'll use this if it is working, okay, and ask them to only supply the animation code as well as the user control code. So separation of the graphics portion and the programming portion was their objective.
So we have another section called optics. The basic UI are almost similar. He can set background and all that stuff we had done in mechanics. So here he is changing the background theme. In optics, basic theme is like lenses, mirror, all these objects can be reused because the equations are same. We tried to animate it in a such a manner where user can add any number of lenses and he gets the where the position of images are, because it follows an equation and similar equation. So we tried to change it, like the user can click and change the focal length and anything of that. So this is a mirror because it has very large focal length, that's why you cannot see it right now. So you can save it and view it again afterwards. So this is what a mirror is. This was a mirror, convex mirror, because it is very thin part. If you increase the focal length there, decrease the focal length, you can see a spherical part also. That was it. Now we will going to show how we integrate Blender in our software.
So Blender is one of the most popular 3D modeling and animation software available in the market right now. The best thing about Blender is it is open source and free to use for all. So in our framework, we integrated Blender as it provides a high quality model and texture for free basically. So we wanted to load objects from Blender and use it in a framework. To do this, we started with making a human heart. The thing about using Blender object in a framework is we have to convert each object into .json file. And Mr. Du has already provided an exporter for that. So we just needed to create a human heart. And if we want to animate in a framework, we wanted to divide it in different pieces so we can control each of the piece of a human heart differently. So if we can have the video, you will have a more clear idea. So what I am doing in this window is taking different objects and making it into one so that I can animate it differently on the 3JS scene. So these are some arteries and veins. So what I'll do next is I'll import these things differently into separate JSONs and I'll have it in my framework and then group it as one single object. And now I'll export it with a 3JSON exporter. Now while doing it, you must ensure that you select face materials and textures because you need them in your scene. Using that, we have uploaded the object into our database. Now we'll just show you how it looks and we'll create another Blender using objects and we'll create another animation using the objects of Blender. So we'll add some lights. So this is the heart, and if you can see clearly there are different portions which are taken from different models. And one thing about, we can perform an open heart surgery here as well. So in this experiment, we are going to take two models from Blender and animate them. We are setting the scene, of course, we need it. We'll take a table from a Blender, that's a free object available online. Now that's a sphere, we are going to rotate a sphere just to show that our framework works and we can do anything with that. We'll have some light. Okay, I tried to add some light effects but I was unsuccessful. Okay, while importing the Blender object, one thing that it gives you a very powerful tool that you can animate it in our framework. The thing with Blender is when you render the animation, it is saved as a video file. So you cannot do anything with that. You can only show it, but we can edit it and we can do anything we want. Now I'll write the animation code for that sphere and I'll rotate it in all the directions. And now you can see that it is rotating. So this proves that our frameworks work for Blender objects as well. So we can create any number of complex animation in our framework too. So this was all about Blender part.
We have a Blender file where there is animation. Like you said, you can export it as video, but you can also export it as a blend file. Now if that has animation, why can't you just import that here?
Okay, sir, the animation which I worked with were one with a rigid model which have some skeleton. The animation what it is running and walking. There were two animation embedded on that model. So what we did is we exported it that .json file and imported our framework. It was able to do the running and walking, but the thing is when you embed animation, we cannot edit it further in our framework. So that's why we prefer it exporting as a separate model. So we can do anything we want.
Will you be able to access the bone information there? Like the rigging information. So suppose we have attached bones here in Blender. Blender allows me to animate this based on the bone structure that I have defined. And that is possible only in Blender, obviously, because that's the software for animation. Now, once you get into this tool, you will be able to animate like rotation, bounce and all that. But if I want the bone to work like this, where there is a series of bones and they should act accordingly, and there are some limitations here, will you be able to give those controls to me here?
Sir, actually due to lack of time, I wasn't able to experiment with that.
You answer theoretically right now. You don't have to show me demo of that. Will you be able to?
Sir, right now I won't be able to do that.
You won't be able to. Okay. So you will be able to do transformations like place, rotate, move, scale.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that
location,
you have tried
rotation,
and
scale.
That is possible.
Yes, sir.
And if you import a animated like walk and all that, it is able to show me as it is,
yes,
but you are not able to edit it. And the answer to that is because the thing which is making it move inside Blender is something called rigging, which is not getting transferred here. So that rig information is not coming here, therefore you are not able to edit it. So maybe as a future work you can keep that if you can study the blend file which has the rig information there, that will help you in demystifying this gap right now, which will enable you to also control the bones from here. Okay, yeah, dot blend has all the information. Okay, you can also go to a website called Sketchfab. So that actually allows you to do exactly what you can do here. Only thing, it is not allowing you to edit things, but you can upload a blend file on Sketchfab and then you can see that animation from various angles, which is right now happening here. It's browser based and you can actually export that HTML and place it anywhere. You can embed it in your own website and things like that can happen. In fact, the latest version of Sketchfab also allows you to upload your games there. So I'm still exploring that how if it is user friendly there, so I can play that game directly there. I think that would be something interesting, and you can also have a look at it because they are a very vibrant website, Sketchfab.
Okay,
thanks.
Now,
good work.
Thank you, sir. Now the Blender pass is done. We'll continue with our presentation. I'll just make it as fast as possible. Oh, these are some metrics. We have covered two topics, optics and mechanics, lines of code approximately 11,000, number of table data by 7, number of objects 37, still counting. What we have learned, first of all, we have learned how to work in a team, and these are some technical knowledge, Vue.js library, database, design, web development, Blender, of course. Now, challenges faced, integration part was very difficult to do. Solving bugs, and we are still solving bugs. Blender integration, of course, and database designing because we didn't take any designing course before. Future work. So Blender, of course, we can add more feature about Blender in the future work. Now, one thing is codeless framework. So what we are offering right now is codeless framework for optics only, because mechanics, we cannot use anything. There's a library called Physics.js, but it's too heavy to use in anything. So codeless framework is what we can do in future. This will be all. Thank you, everyone.